Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Air Holler with me, Mirhood 37. So back in the 767, finally it's the weekend again so I can get to flying again, and we have a flight set up here, Tunis to Dublin. Which is kind of weird because I've been actually trying to do a flight from Rome to Dublin, FSX flight, so be around the same time, maybe. It's going to take a while to get that thing done. It's all done, but now I got to do all the stuff, put it together. It's kind of lengthy. But yeah, Tunis to Dublin. 91,000 pounds, a little over our weight, but that's not bad. It's like 1,208 miles, I think, with the SID and everything. There is no SID, but the Star. It's actually a little, I think it's like 1,250 or 1,290, something around there. So be well within everything on the specs. You can take tons of fuel with the 767. I just want to fly this thing. I just moved over. I can't remember where. We went to LIJC, something like that. Got it moved over. All right, it's already loaded up. I thought I had the fuel in there. Apparently not. So I was going to put it about 15. I think that should be fine right there. Give us 1,517. Should be well within everything. All right. So we got to do a day flight. Yeah, we'll keep it there at noon. Let's select where I don't think we're a heavy. I think we would probably be a large. All this is, well, there's some gates here. This is general aviation. I don't know if that would include us. We'll go here. I really don't want to go through the gate because we're a cargo plane. I don't know. We'll say we're a large right here at this ramp. General aviation large. We'll take that, ramp 5. And let's go ahead and meet on over at the plane. Alright everybody, here we are. The plane is actually started up. I put this on pause because, as you know, if you've been watching these, it's extremely loud from the outside. So I wanted to pause it for you. At least for the headphone users, there's some lights around here. Pretty nice. So let's go back in here. I'll unpause this. The plane is not completely set up. I use Control E to get the engine started. We'll eventually use some procedures on it. It's not too difficult. Let me pause my mic for 1 second. Alright, so let's go down here to the FMC. Let's see if I can get this thing to work correctly. Alright, so I'm going to copy this in to our position. I'll wait just a second before I turn this over. I've got it in online, so let's give it 1 second. I don't know how, it might be in Captain Sim, you can do it immediately, I'm not sure. So put those in nav, yaw damper comes on. Alright, looks like it's got it working. Alright, let me come down over here now. Let's see if we can get the route in. It's kind of weird how it happened before. I can't remember if we have to do the request. And see, actually, there it is. DTTAEIDW. Sweet. It even has the runway in there. Activate. Execute. Let's check out the legs here because I want to see if it actually. Usually, I don't put the SID and the Star in. This one didn't have a SID, but I did put the Star in and saved it that way. Okay, so Oslex. Alright, so it did end at Oslex, so if I want to do one thing. Oslex. I think it is actually coming in. I can actually check that out. Alright, so we can use the SEP on this. Probably increase the range just a little bit so we can see it better. We'll zoom out here. Let's go step by step. I think Oslex was actually the end of it, so it looks like it might actually be in there. I don't know why there's so much magenta stuff on there, but okay. There's Lipko. I don't think that'll ruin anything, but check this out. That's kind of weird. Detax to Burmo, it doesn't complete. I think that is actually right, though. There's one thing I can do. Because see how it comes in over there? We should come in smoother. Although, that is correct. That is how the start ended. It was at Oslex. But I've got two waypoints I'd like to put in there, Rissep and Gannett. I think I should be able to do that. Let's just go down here. The only thing is this is going to take EIDW away. I wish I could move that down. Alright, might be able to do it anyway. Rissep. R-I-S-A-P. Alright, so EIDW just actually came down. So Rissep and then Gannett. G-A-N-E-T. Gannett. And then we should actually come straight over into to our runway. Execute that. Although, probably next time I should leave off the star, probably, because let's see if it says anything. 01. What does it say about the star? Does it even have our star in there? It's LIP. JK. It goes from K to N. It doesn't even have ours in there, which is LIPG1Z. Oh, I'll tell you why. Runway 1 is what we're taking off on. Which is, this is the departures. I've noticed that before. It does that. Index. Alright, there we go. So if I want to go on 10, see it doesn't have, it's actually 10. There's LIP, see, so I should probably save it without it, because I know if I'm afraid if I mess with that. So it's still going to work this way. See, it took out EIDW there at the end. I don't understand why it does that. So I've had problems with that last time. Alright, I'm going to go ahead. I didn't want to do this, but I'm going to try it anyway. See, it goes straight to departures. That's what screws me up. So let's say ILS 10 LIPG1Z. Let me just make sure, yeah, that's it. I'm not sure. I think it, Auslex is what we want to transition. Let's enter that. Now let's see if that screwed it up. But it went from 10 pages to 13. Lipco, there's Auslex. Now, Auslex, see, this is what happens. And that comes back to Rissep and all this. Alright, so what I'm going to do is just take Gannett, runway 10. And can we just delete these on the end? Or is that where it was going to go around? See, it's got a 30,000. Go to the previous page. See, that's 300 feet, so obviously Gannett, we don't want to be at 30,000. This is what kind of screws things up. I won't do that just yet, because we still got other stuff to put in. It's just kind of a weird plane like that. Get used to how it wants to do things. I want to get over somewhere else. There we go. That's what I wanted. Alright, so we have to enter our zero fuel weight on this plane. Now, pause it. I'm not sure that I know how to do this correctly. This is how I've seen other people do it. Let's go to our aircraft fuel and payload. And we'll just click change that. No, that's not actually what we're going to do. Right here. Here is what we need. So, I'll do it. Let me see. I can't do it unless we go to window mode to show the calculator. Just move off the full screen. Alright, can I bring up my calculator and still keep it on there? Yes. So let's go over to this fuel and payload. Bring up the calculator. So I believe what we do here is take the gross weight and then gross weight minus the fuel. So gross weight 345,200 minus 56,692 leaves us at 288,000. So I believe we use 288. Let's make this full screen again. 288. and you can tell me if that's wrong. But that is our zero fuel weight. Reserves, we'll say 4. Cruising altitude, let's go 34,000. So that's probably going to change those altitudes. So I didn't want to mess with that just yet. Cost index, we'll say 75. Now you go over here to takeoff. Let's say we're going to use 15 degrees of flaps. Now, I can't do center of gravity. I don't know how to do that, so we're going to have to leave that out. See, that because of that, we can't get our trim, so I just leave the trim right there in the middle of the green. But V2 is going to be 153. That was weird how that did that. Okay, 153. But you'll notice, like, I had the clicking sounds and stuff again. I don't know. This plane is so weird. I had so many problems with it. Now let's check this out. Because the VNAV won't work correct. And that Lipko, those became separated, didn't they? Lipko. But we don't want to reset Gannett. That's, then we should be at the next one. Why is it Lipko? See, I think it brought the star over to here. So I'm going to take runway 10. Nah, it won't let me do it. Damn it. See, I shouldn't have saved it with the star. So I'm gonna delete all this crap. But see, it has the right altitudes. Rhubar. You on here, Rhubar? Rhubar's on there. Rhubar. Which one should I put it at Rhubar? See, I deleted the one. That goes back to 11, and now it's got the right altitudes. Oslex. I don't think that's going to be a problem. I'll move it up anyway. I should probably do that to the other one, and Lipko. And now it should bring us incorrectly. So that just having that saved it with the star and then putting the star in, it screwed everything up. Lipko, then I don't know why it's saying Lipko and then runway 10. Lipko shouldn't even be in there. It should be Gannett and then the runway. Enter. Now we've got the correct altitude. Sweet. Because last time I had to put those in there myself. Learning more and more about this plane. Approach, of course this speed will change, but we'll say 142. Okay, so 160, we actually want to be at 147 when we get there. And let's see, that's 4 miles, so let's say we make it 165, so we're not coming in too slow. 5 miles before that, we'll say we're going to be at 185. This plane does seem to slow down pretty quick. It's 185, and then 11 miles before that, 230. I'll slow that to 215. And everything else should be okay, because we'll have time to slow down. Get back over to nav. Everything should be good now. It took a little while. We're starting to figure out. Parking brake is the only error. That's fine. We want the parking brake on. Our takeoff on runway 1 is going to be 011 degrees. So 011, flight director on both arm LNAV and VNAV. Go ahead and turn on our taxi light. Well, no, we shouldn't do that. Other lights are on, by the way. Position and the red lights. Alright, so let's know where we're taking off. And you know what? We never told this thing what we're taking off on. That shouldn't screw anything up. Alright. But now it should be on our screen here, I do believe. Taking off over this way. I'm not sure that actually did. turn on the TCAS, hit the traffic button. So you see the traffic. All right, parking brake is off. We're gonna go ahead and push back. All right, look out, headphone users. I believe this is our runway. So we can just taxi right over here. All right, sorry about that, headphone users. No, she's loud. I'm not sure why it's so loud. The engine sounds better from outside than in here. I'll tell you what, the APU on here is extremely loud, even when you're in the cockpit. I turned that off and she caught it down quite a lot earlier when I was starting up. I need to make this, sure, this gets to 34,000. I wish you could use the middle mouse button on this thing. I don't think you can. One of those that takes a little while. So you can see it says TCAS fail, but once we take off, it works. It's one of those things. $30,000. We eventually get there. There we go, $34,000. These taxi lines. By the way, we do have EIDW scenery for that. And I've got Morvex's Ireland on there as well. See, I was making an FSX video, so I already had those installed. Turn, she's not wanting to turn the tail. So we're gonna take off over here. Taxi over there, I should say. Alright, so let's go ahead in the pushback. Taxi light coming on. Alright, let's go ahead and taxi on over to our left. I know I've been turning this plane. I've been horrible turning this plane. Taxi straight down this way and then over to the left. This is where we're going to be. I think there's a taxi line over there. No. There's parking over there. Here in Carthage. Well, it was saying something as well as Tunis. I hope we didn't have to turn there. No. Over here. Hopefully there's a taxi line over there. Yeah, right there at the end. Alright, just so I don't forget, I'll go ahead and put the flaps out to 15. I think it's 1515. Check it here in a second. Looks like it's going to 15. I think it is 1515, 2025, something like that, 30. Brakes are in RTO, directing takeoff, so that's good. Like I said, that we'll just keep the trim right there in the middle. It's kind of weird that it usually has... See, it doesn't really show runway 1 like it would normally show up, I do believe. Somebody over there. I couldn't tell which runway we should use. I took one. There is another one you could also use. It's just the wind was kind of odd. So I chose to take off on runway 1 to the north. That got taxi. Lights are on. I wonder if I should... The nose gear when we're taxiing. I'm not sure. Strobes coming on. We should be all set up for takeoff. Laps are in 15. I'm gonna say no one over there, no one over here. We got that plane taxiing. Looks like there's nobody else taxiing. Is there an Air Tunisia, maybe? Air Tunis? No. Auto throttles armed. Oh, that'd be never good. I'm gonna get up in the air. A pretty long runway as well. Alright, get her lined up for a second. I have a real hard time taxiing with this plane, I'm not sure why. Not quite full power. Come on, girl, she's ripped to left on me. Alright. Pick it up, man. She's really finicky on the controls. Pull back just a little bit, she goes real nose up. Gears coming up, we have that messed up sound. And still, like already, she's if I let go, she wants to go to the left, or I'm sorry, to the right. We've had that problem constantly. Alright, fully retract the flaps, and the nose comes straight down. Holy hell. Flight director obviously wants us to go to the left, but like I say, it did. There is no sit here. Man, she's really sensitive on the controls. I'm trying not to get her jagged. Try to do it smoothly. Pull back on the power here. Climbing over 3,000 feet, and look at a minute, and look at our speed. We're already over 250, which obviously we don't want to be. Cross 250 until you're over 2,000 feet. Like I say, we're going at 3,000 feet a minute. I'm going to cut back on the power even more. Come back over to the left. And that speed. Cut back the power even more. We're even climbing up, well, slightly. There's the nose has come down a little bit. Now, the auto throttles, it's almost like it's engaged because look, it's moving on its own. I don't mod. Go ahead and use this. Now, why does that click off the LNAV and VNAV? I honestly don't know. She's trying to climb too hard. What is the altitude set at? That is completely wrong. What night? Oh, plane, why are you doing this? We should have checked those altitudes. I guess maybe because we don't have a SID. So it wants to get up to 19? Are you kidding me? Climbing at 5,000 feet a minute, that's real nice. Although we're already at 9,200 feet, none of the nose is coming down. Good lord. Turned into a cluster. I guess if we had a SID, it would have been better. Turn that off. So the TCAS works now. See 40 miles out. Crest 10,000. Lane lights can all come off. That was odd, though, how she got up there like that. And now she's actually leveling off because she climbed so quick. Still got 18 miles to climb another, what, 8,000, a little over 8,000 feet? Or maybe it was just because we had just turned that on so the nose went straight up. I don't know. It was definitely odd. But I don't know why I turned on the autopilot. Took off LNAV and VNAV, which is armed for it. I guess maybe we don't need to hit that until we take off, but on some of these planes, you've got to be pointed to where you're going before you can even hit LNAV. Let's see how long it's expected to take. Fuel. So we'll still have tons of fuel. We're not burning as much as we think, but we'll have to take it easy on the fuel, not put so much in. But we're supposed to be there 14:14. So, 2.5 hours. Close to 2.5 hours. Not quite 2.5 hours. Something like that. But with that, probably go ahead and speed her up. Nothing really to see around here. Well, we can't take a look outside though. So, look out, headphone users. It actually is quite dense. I don't know if that's still carpet or not. In Tunisia. Headphone users are here good now. Alright, so we're already at 15,000 feet. I'm going to go ahead and speed her up. We'll be back in just a little bit. Alright, everybody, slowing it down to normal speed. Just crossed 13,000 feet. Way down. Auto brakes are set to 2. The speed brake is armed. He decreased the range on here so you can see a little better. I want to check one thing. I don't know if this thing will move the speed or not. It actually says 144 now. So increased it. 144. It used to be actually 149. Alright. 149, 149. Go back over to the first page. So we do have a little ways to go here. Up and around the runway 10. 291 is our current heading. I've been switching it around some. 292. At 10,300 feet. I guess that's Ireland, right? Yeah. There's over the sea. Like I said, we do have FTX Ireland installed. I wonder if it's just going to do the frame rate. So we're already down like 2023 with the weather and everything. Clouds. I should have let it go a little bit longer. I stopped it kind of quick. But also we have the Dublin Airport, which is by Airsoft. That's in there. That's going to hit the frame rate a little bit more. Like I said, I did that FSX flight and I've already landed and everything on that one. So I know it is it's kind of jagged. Did the MD-11 with that flight. I'm going to check it out. It's kind of blurry from up here. About to cross 10,000 feet. Alright, so the plane has already slowed down. I wish I could click that FMC and bring it up, but I can't. As we cross the... I'm going to go ahead and turn on the taxi light as well. Turn on the landing lights. Okay, so 149 is our landing speed. Alright, so that was the end of it, Oslex was the end of it, and I took it, that's Oslex, and I took it over to Recep and Gannett. Those are the ones I put in, down the runway 10. Just make sure that runway 10, it does have it like 0 feet. It says 300, it's actually 20 feet is the airport elevation. Reset my altimeter. By the way, I did get an apartment, which is going to be nice. It's a real small apartment, though. It's a studio apartment, and I can't wait to get moved down there. I can do a lot more flying. As you all probably noticed, the output has been lagging lately. I actually have plenty of videos where it's just, I do all that driving to work and back and all this time that we put into work, even though we're not doing much. It does get quite tiring, and I got to deal with that laptop of editing everything, which is a pain, that laptop. Oh, jeez. Comes time to put everything out, I'm not doing it. Man, we've already got snow. It's like middle of October. I don't know why everything looks kind of blurry. That's weird because the other video has been fine. We've got this on a range of 40. We could probably move that down to 20 now. Everything's getting a little jagged here, although we've got tons of clouds and everything. I guess maybe it's not real blurry, but it's just kind of the way the landscape looks. It's kind of a rugged landscape. I don't like that it's jaggedy because we aren't even to the airport yet. We're already like half of what we want to be. See, Babylon, that's kind of pointless. You could just go up to Oslix. But I'll leave it, because that's the way it put it in. Well, if I was by myself, I'd really just take out Babon. It's just kind of a pointless sway point from here. So 230, and then once we get down towards 215, I'll start putting the flaps out. But as you all know, in the last flight, it slows it down too daggone quick. It slows it down, instead of getting that speed right at the waypoint, it slows it down automatically like that for the next waypoint. Should be one thing if it took a while to slow down, but as you can see, it slows down so quick. So I already dropped it down to 215, and once we get that waypoint, I'll go ahead and start putting some flaps out. The textures actually look pretty nice. It's weird, there were some black areas. I couldn't figure out why that was happening last time. I don't know if there should be spots of snow like that or not. .100 will be the heading, by the way. Why back up to 240? I'm going to put the flaps out to 1. What the hell did it do to the speed? Why is the speed 240? It should be 185. What the hell? Put the flaps out to 5. See if that will let it bring it down. There it comes down.
Check landing gear.
See, I don't want the landing gear down
check
yet.
Landing gear position. Check landing gear position.
I'm gonna move this to 100, by the way.
Check landing gear position.
Before we do that.
Check landing gear
position. It shouldn't be a landing gear problem.
Landing gear position.
I'll go ahead and put it down. We shouldn't have it down yet though.
Check landing gear.
It's ridiculous. I guess once you get to 5 degrees, it wants the daggone landing gear down, but it's ridiculous. We don't need the landing gear down at 5 degrees flaps. See, there's areas like that. I'm not sure quite why. There's another one. I mean, we're not even at 2,500 feet, we're at 6,000. See if it says anything. So I'll leave it up instead, to see if I turn it off, back to the off. Happens. Alright. We don't need the landing gear out like that. I'm afraid if I mess with the flaps, it'll do it again. Wow, the areas like that. Well, no, I was going to say it's trees now, but see, there's areas like that. Almost kind of looks like water sometimes and mud. I don't know. ILS frequency is 108.9. I checked the nav radio. It's in there. Well, let's check one other thing. It's 27.2. Good lord, that's so much fuel. Nav, you can see 108.9, it says 099, I've got it as 100, not a big deal. Alright, moving the flaps to 15 as it's moved our speed up again. I think it's doing that because it's having a hard time staying aloft because we don't have much flaps up.
Check landing gear position.
This still out too early. She's already going to 160. She's trying to slow down, but she had her sped up so much. Let's say flaps are at 15. We're a little below where we need to be. I like how it starts yelling at you about the landing gear position. Man, you're only at 5 degrees flaps. Flaps going to 20. She's not whining about it now, which is surprising. Number approach speed is 149. Let's see, it's moved it up again. Unreal. Autocross coming off. That's dumb. And it's going to say drag needed on the FMC. It needs drag because you're screwing with the speed. So I'll handle that. The localizer. It's the airport ahead. We're below the glide slope, so we need this thing to stop that. Putting in some more throttle. That's our landing speed right there. Well, that's 149, that's our approach speed, you can say. So hopefully we hold with our altitude so I can hit the approach hold. Yeah, the speed is being fickle. Approach hold. Put this at... Oh, jeez, don't do that. Well, it doesn't matter. Because auto throttles are already cut, really, so... Speed's a little high here. Cut it back. Dropping the gear. Well.
2500.
We did just get a 2500 feet foot call out, which is kind of odd. Our speed is way too fast. Flaps are at 25. Speed is finally coming down. We're a little above the glide slope here. Alright, we're at full flaps. Have you ever seen the Pappy lights? Everything looks pretty good. I'm worried about this speed here. She keeps dropping down. The area I'm on my joystick with that thing is right at the notch. Alright, see, land 3. So auto land is good. We're not going to auto land it, obviously. Frame rate isn't too bad. Well, it's at 15, but it feels pretty smooth. There's a little bit of jack in this, obviously. We have our radio altimeter right there. Alright, so we're at 1,000.
Autopilot disengaged.
As you heard, autopilot is disengaged. still feel like we're a little fast. Now it's getting jagged. Yep, we're moving right. We're moving right. I don't know why. Every time we've flown it, it wants to go right. Makes it extremely hard to land.
500.
Starting to get low here. Damn it, get left, bitch. Slow. This is ridiculous trying to steer this thing left. Better use my rudder a little bit more.
100. 50. 40. 30. 20.
She's really hard to land, though it says greaser. Off the auto throttles. Man, it's... The haptic steer left is not really open to anything. Retracting the flaps. Stop you. That's why we're off to the right so much. I'm trying to use that rudder and hope it's to get left. I'm surprised, because when we hit the tent, I was flaring, and it almost felt like it was keeping the plane from coming down, but if you looked at our speed at that time, it was well low. But it still felt like it was almost like we were going to gain altitude or float a little bit. Which is odd. Because I don't know why you would float at all. Our speed was so low. I'm looking at that. T-cast standby. I think the landing light, that nose gear, I don't know if that should be off or not. I'll turn it off. I don't know how that's still on. Flight director, I'll go ahead and turn that off. Auto brakes are disarmed, and I'll turn that off. And I guess we'll go right over here. It's more of a cargo area. I saw a plane, I think it was a Ryanair, landing going to our left. That was kind of odd, because I planned this just before we flew it, or looked at the wind to decide on the runway. It was perfect the way we were coming in. Even taxiing, she wants to go to the right a little bit. I don't know what all that's about. By the way, should we be turning here? Is there another taxiway? Watch out, headphone users. Okay, so we need to cut to our left to get over there. Pretty nice airport. I actually did an FSX flight long ago with it. I went from London Heathrow to here in a 747. That was a different kind of FSX flight. My FSX flights were in the beginning were not what they are now. It was mainly just me liking to do the whole startup and shutdown process, and that was what I was calling FSX flights. A little different now. Lots of planes here. I really do like that. Here in good old Dublin. Let's see where we should park her. I think we'll just go straight ahead and park her there. 610. Should be just as good as any. That dropped the speed a little bit. Come on, girl. Stop the noise right over, right about here. That's pretty good, actually. Let's check it. Now, I don't want headphone users will complain. It's gonna be real loud in the route. No kidding. You don't say. Where is my parking brake? I just turned that on though. Now it's on. There's the parking brake is on. Should have turned the strobes off. I turned the landing lights off, but I forgot to turn the strobe off. Let's see. This APU will get really loud. Turn on the bleed for it. Here's spooling up already. I should have set the landing altitude, I guess. APU generator is on. Well, it says it's on, but it says it's actually off. I don't know if it hasn't spooled up yet. You can hear how loud is that? Man, it's shriekingly loud. Cut the fuel. Alright, so we've got it from here. Just go ahead and move on over to Air Hauler and get this thing paid. Alright, here we are. No damage. Alright. We got a range of 671 miles, but it should have been like 300. It gave us an extra 300 or so, so we had another 300 or so. So next time, I guess, won't put so much fuel in it. Basically, just enough to get us there, and we should still have plenty after that. Maybe go around or anything like that. Come on, Air Hauler, you're so slow. There we go. Alright, and we're up here in good old Dublin. One of our bases. There we go, EIDW, and then there should be a lot of... Oh my goodness, wouldn't you know it. The one I click on goes down to, what was that, Rio? SBGL, that's Sao Paulo, isn't it? No, it is Rio de Janeiro. Find Dublin. The one I click goes all the way down, takes us off. There we go, Dublin. There should be plenty of flights. Dublin to Denver, that would be nice, but it's only 100 grand. We'd lose so much. Conte, there's two going down there. St. Martin, oh, that would be fun. That's really heavy, though. That's like double what we can do. Man, all these flights are so long. What is that? Valladolid? Something like that in Spain, I think. That pays really good. 722 grand. It's perfume, so it's fragile. That's why it pays so good. But it's a short flight, to be quite honest. But it pays. Look at that. 700 grand. There's one actually coming back to it. What is it? Valladolid back to Dublin. And I mean, still at 229 grand for 700 miles. Still pays pretty good. That's got 39 hours left on it. What was the one from Dublin? So I'd have plenty of time to do that. Is there plenty of time on this one, though? That is not Dublin. I saw the fragile thing on it. 44 hours. So we got plenty of time to do that. That'd be awesome. Be able to do that. I don't know. I gotta get this place cleaned up. I gotta get stuff ready at my storage unit because I'm getting ready to move. Like I said, I signed a lease on an apartment. Probably still be at least a couple weeks till I get there, though. Hey, alright, though. That's gonna be it for this episode. I hope you all did enjoy it. I'll catch you guys on the next flight.